Hi friends, all a nice evening. I have not picked the last package from the quiz completely, but already a new package from quiz arrived today. but before I will open this, I want to say thank you to some friends. And when I came back on Saturday from my Christmas vacation, I found a very, very nice Christmas card from Locknoob in my mailbox. So thank you very much, Ash, for sending this to me. Even I found it very late. And I also want to thank Mark. We had a little trade just before Christmas, and he was so nice to send me some very, very beautiful star locks. And you might have seen similar ones. I'm not that sure. They were heavily corroded on the shackle, but I did give him a good grind here, so that they look a little bit better now. But they're brand new. They're just stored in a maybe wet condition or so. I'm not that sure. And the shackle actually is relatively soft, I think. I don't know if you can see this, because with a light touch of sandpaper I already grinded into the shackle a little bit. But anyway, very, very cool star locks. We pick very nicely and I love them. I've given some away and don't know if I have already some of mine left. And also in the package was a very cute fox like this here. I think it was even the identical one. And it was sitting in our Christmas tree this year. And I left it there, so it stays with the Christmas stuff. And most likely will sit next year also in the tree. But now let's put the locks to the side and get Chris' package open. I'm very, very curious. Let's see, I probably won't need the knife. I will just whip it open here on the side. Okay, take a first look. Oh, no way. I did have a first glance. And we come to the chocolate first. Reese's peanut butter cups. This is very cool. And I know where Chris gets his stuff from. Okay, let's take out the next part. There's another pack of sweets here. Reese's Nutragius. I have no idea how it is pronounced. Looks very tasty. Very, very cool. Thank you. So, now let's get to the locks. I think this were the sweets. And here we have, oh, a Bill Bacardi number 122. I'm not that sure if I had a Bill Bacardi lock. I don't think so. And I'm very happy I have one. And I think this is the only lock I did new, which was in the package. All the other stuff, I have no idea. 122, it's really a lot. Man, a very beautiful kickcylinder. I really like them. And a very nice key. It looks like a Schlage key. SC key V. Oh, he has even stamped the number here in the key. That's great. Wow. And marked the font. I had it a couple of times that I assembled a lock and had it backwards. So I always make also a little mark on the font here. There's a little hanging here in the middle. Don't know if you can see it. So I expect something a bit nasty here inside, but I'm very, very sure it will be a great lock from Bill. He's really an awesome fan. And I think he asked Chris forwarding this lock to me. So thank you both very, very much. Okay, let's get to the next one. Oh, there's a very beautiful key. I have whipped my thumbnail a little bit off yesterday when I worked on a air pressure valve. So it hurts a bit. It's not that easy to work with it at the moment. Oh, this lock looks a bit unusual. At least the end piece here. It's pretty long. It looks like another kickcylinder with a 5, and it is a Spool Me Once by Pickaholic. I don't think I had a Pickaholic lock before. This is awesome, and I really like this painted key. Broncos. Very nice, wow. Oh, I can already see some nastiness here. I will zoom in the light a bit. Hope you can see this. This first pin. Okay. I will keep this together. Let's get the next one out. Okay, here it is. Oh! It's a Trackmaster. Trackmaster 30, another kickcylinder, man. Very cool. I really love this. And it's a little bit clamped here on the top. I expect Trackmaster had the top off. Ah, and I can again see some nastiness here on the first pin. There are some deep serrations. It is called Psycho. Or Psycho. It looks again like a Schlägki. Okay, it is. I love the shape here. It's very nice. Let's see how it works. Very, very nice. And again, with a little hang here in the middle. So, nice things to expect. And okay. I think it might take me a bit to get the key back out. Ah, with a little bit of wiggling. Okay. Maybe the bidding is a bit extreme. Very, very nice. Trax locks are not that easy. I've had at least some locks from him. Okay, let's get the next one. For Foxy. So this is for me. And another kickcylinder. Oh, this is really, really awesome. And here the key is mummied. I think here... Oh. I won't unpack it now. I can see a little fox head here at the top. I will. Yeah, it looks like a key, so I will leave it together. No, it is not. Here are the keys. No key available. Okay, I will still leave it unpacked, even I found the keys here, and unpack it when I pick the lock. I sadly have no idea who made this lock, but maybe I will find out. Oh, works so nice. Nice. Again, not that easy to get the key out. Nice and sharp cuts here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Nice 5-pin lock. Very cool. Another Schläg. Okay. Thank you very much. Whoever made this. Okay, let's see. I see more inside. Oh, here's a little. Let's see, it's an Abus 85. 8540. No key, but that doesn't matter. It's not a sad face, it's a smile face. Yeah, I love Abus 85s. And it looks original, so no mods done. We pick usually very, very nice. Thank you very much. And, oh, I believe it, I've already seen it. And wow. Oh man. Another Bill Bacardi lock. Very cool. Number 121. Okay, it's a predecessor to this one here. I will lay them out in a second. And this one is an ICO. Bill Bacardi, made in Italy, number 120. Oh, holy cow. I'm not that great at dimple locks. Oh, this looks really nasty. It's a very, very deep cut here in the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 in the third position. Oh, very cool kiwi. Hope you can see it well. Check it out. Oh, it works like butter. Oh, it works so smooth. The plugs are all still in, so probably nothing is serrated or threaded inside the Bible at least. But it really works beautiful. Wow, and the key is huge. Wow, I'm happy looking forward to this. As I said, I'm not that great at dimple lock picking. But I'm always willing to learn. So let's see, we have another track lock here. And this is up all night. I'm usually up pretty long all day. It's a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 pin lock. Let's see, I don't think this is fitting. And this is a round cylinder. Excuse that I don't know which brand it is. But the kiwi is okay. Can be nicely tensioned on the bottom usually. Yeah, fits very nicely here in. And it has this screw end, which is really great because I hate these tension clips, and it works really good. Yeah, a little hang again, and the core is a bit floppy. But that has nothing to say. It can be a big surprise here. And again, the key doesn't want to come out. Okay. If I don't get it out, I will try later carefully. Yeah, I will try this carefully, get out. With a little bit of wiggling, it will do the job. There's supposedly a very, very nasty stuff inside when the key even doesn't come out. And I have not turned it 180. I did the mistake once. And here, last but not least, but this is so great. Oh, this is really too much. Oh, Chris, man. I don't know if you know what this is. This is the SSDev pick kit. Wow. I actually wanted to buy them soon, because Chris sends always locks with very, very high pins, and I never can reach them properly. The best pick I have for these is the Sparrow's deep hook, which is relatively slim, but even this is often not enough. And oh wow, now I have some really great and deep picks. Wow, this is really cool. I will cut this down, and maybe I make handles for them later. Oh, and this one here is this one is really thin. I think Chris has made this heat tubing himself over it, and it looks like a Sparrow's pick. You can often tell because of this bend here. Don't know if you can see this properly. Most of the sparrow's picks make this bend down here on the side. I'm not that sure. I think it is the same or thinner. But I will find out. But wow, this is so great. And trust me, such a very thin and pointy deep hook is really, really helpful when you pick nasty European locks with this paracentric kiwis. Wow. And of course, I will send soon Chris package from me. Wow, this is really so awesome here. Wow. I love this key here. Oh man. Thank you so much, Chris, and also Bill and Trackmaster. This is really a great package. I will have so much fun picking them. Especially because I like really these kick cylinders. Wow. I'm a little bit speechless. So thank you all, my fans, and have a great evening. See you in the next picking video. Bye.